to John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you here in Oakland, California at the Convention Center. And there's a compost convention going on. I'm so excited to be here. This is celebrating compost, reusing, recycling, all that good stuff. So we're going to go inside the compost con and share with you guys what's going on. I think this is an excellent idea, the first compost con of its kind that I've seen anywhere. I think they should have these all over to educate people about truly making compost and using that compost to grow more food at home so that you guys could eat out of your garden instead of the grocery store. So let's come inside the compost con, check it out. So now we're here inside the compost con, and this place is pretty huge. They got a lot of different exhibitors. They got actually a stage with a compost band playing some down home music. There's a little eating area here, and there's lectures basically every hour to teach you something about composting. So first, let's go ahead and share with you guys a booth that has equipment to do this on a commercial scale, but also explain to you how you could do it at home. So now we're at the booth of Green Mountain Technology, and they produce large systems to compost on an industrial scale. Here's their smallest system, actually. It's about $10,000. It's called the Earth Tub to basically make compost if you're like a big school or place that produce a lot of waste. Now, you guys don't need one of these systems if you guys want to compost at home. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to take you and show you guys the two easiest ways to produce compost at home. So the best way to compost at your home is just to have a standard thermophilic pile. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take your food waste, whether it's, you know, old bread you didn't eat, leaves or fish bones, or other food scraps and yard waste, yard clippings. You wanna try to reduce them down to the smallest particle size. So now that you've got all the organics, or mostly the greens, then you're gonna add in the browns. The browns are like the leaves, shredded up trees, sawdust, basically a carbon source, whether you're gonna get that from paper or cardboard that's shredded up really fine. You're gonna basically mix those two together in the right ratio and compost will happen. Whether you wanna get a static bin, whether you wanna get some pallets and make them into a little square and pile up the compost in there, whether you wanna buy a $300 tumbling composter like I use, you could easily make compost at home, and the compost you make at home is going to be far better, in my opinion, than probably anything that they're doing on a large industrial scale, because you'll get to tend to it yourself, you get to put your intention into it, and you'll be sure to add the right things in there to ensure you're going to have the richest compost, such as the rock dust, the biochar, and other things that I add to my compost. Be sure to check my other videos on YouTube where I show you guys how exactly to compost, how to build your composting skills, to dial it in so that you can do it effectively and really, put a dent in how much garbage and how much stuff is coming out of your house. You can keep it on site and use your resources, on site to grow some food. So the second way to make compost at home is with composting worms. So they have a vermicomposting system here, and I basically pick up inside here. Oh, there's a lot of little worms here. You guys can see that, check it out. There's worms in there. And the worms eat the garbage. They eat the food and they turn it into the valuable worm castings. Now, if you go to buy worm castings for your garden, it's gonna definitely cost a lot of money. Oh yeah, and it has a nice earthy smell, so there's no smells involved if you got the right ratio of food, waste, and moisture. Now, I know what some of you guys might be thinking. You might be thinking, John, I don't wanna compost at home, man, get like dirty and then it gets smelly and it's just a hassle. So for those of you guys that don't want to make your own compost at home, that's all right, and you live in the Bay Area, you want to come visit a local composting facility that collects and composts the municipal waste for you. So what I'm going to do next now is go over a few of these, actually, that are located in the Bay Area. So of course, the one that I use is Sonoma Compost. They're located in Sonoma County. They make an excellent compost product. Be sure to check my past videos where I actually got out to Sonoma Compost to make my recommendations for you guys on the compost that I would choose to use if I bought from them. So if you live in Alameda County, you're gonna wanna check out WM Earthcare. They have two locations, one in San Leandro and one in Livermore, where you can actually buy the compost. It's made with the yard waste and the food scraps from the local area. All right, we're having some fun with the compost boys here at the compost con. They got a band and they're just rocking out here. I think what we're gonna do next, maybe check out a few more booths here at the compost con. So if you live in Santa Clara County, you're gonna wanna visit Zanker products. And what they have is they have this really cool Z-Best organic compost. This is what it looks like, nice, dark, and rich. Let me go ahead and smell that stuff. Like, there's no odor to this stuff. I mean, this stuff is fully compost and actually just a really nice texture. Now, besides having a place in San Jose, they also have a location where you can pick up the compost also in Gilroy. So if you're living anywhere in that part of the Bay, you want to check out zankerproducts.com to learn more and even order online. After all, they are located in the Silicon Valley. So I know what some of you guys are thinking. You're like, John, I don't live in the Bay Area. I can't get any good compost in my area because there's no big companies that like make it that I could just drive to and pick it up by the truckload. Well, this is for those of you guys that live in the West Coast from Canada to Mexico or from Utah to Hawaii. You guys can get this stuff right here. These are the Kellogg's products, and these are available at the big box stores. As much as I may not like the big box stores, they do serve a valuable purpose to allow you to get some good compost and some good materials out to you guys. Of course, Kellogg's also has a line that's distributed by, you know, independent nurseries and whatnot, which is also good. But I like that these are available at most big box stores, whether it's a Lowe's or a Home Depot. And the coolest thing that they have is these are all organic, and they have a new formulation that I was excited to see here. It's actually called the Raised Bed Potting Mix. And this is specifically designed for raised beds. So you're just gonna buy this stuff in the bag, dump it in your raised bed, maybe add some rock dust too, because I don't see that on the ingredient label, and you'll be ready to plant out. So I really like that a lot. And the other thing I want to point out is that Kellogg's is OMRI listed. It's all organic. They're not using any biosolids. They used to use it in the past, but no longer do they do that. They're definitely a good company. I've talked to them at length about this subject, and hopefully one of these days I'll be able to visit their facility and make a video for you guys to show you guys how this stuff is made, because they told me they have an open door policy. And I think this is really important to just be upfront and be transparent in, you know, what's going on with producing the products. And so far, I definitely think they got some good products, and I'm looking forward to using them in the future. So another cool booth here at the Compost Con is this booth. Actually, it's called the Tiny Tots, and what they have and they're educating people about is compostable diapers. You know, a lot of diapers, those big brands, are made out of plastics, and they take a long time, if ever, do they ever decompose and degrade. They now have compostable diapers. Now, better than compostable diapers, in my opinion, is reusable diapers. And hopefully one of these days, awesome kids will be able to use some reusable or compostable diapers. And here's one of the brands here. It's actually called the Nady by Nature Baby Care. And these are GMO-free, corn-based film, natural and reusable materials, and naturally breathable and chlorine and fragrance-free. So if you want to have a natural baby and then compost their poop, you could do it with these compostable diapers. Definitely something you might want to look into if you got some babies in the house. All right, so I have another cool booth to show you guys, and what this is we're at the Garden Soxx booth. That's Garden SOXX.com. You can check it out online. What they sell is a garden sock. So this might look like a big sock for a big person or maybe somebody's pants, but this is actually a big sock. So it's actually a tubular, and they tied it off to one end. And besides using it actually for gardening, if you ever want to rob a bank, stick them up, give me all your money. But anyways, no, but seriously, this is for growing some food at home. Works really cool. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take some compost and fill it up in here. You can just use 100% compost, although I would mix in a few other things, and be sure to check my other videos on the mixture that I would use if I was growing inside a garden sock. And then you can even set it up with an irrigation system like they have here. And then you're just gonna basically cut a few holes and plant some plants. And look, they got some lettuce growing in here and some flowers. I mean, this is a super simple way to start growing some food on top of your lawn, on top of some concrete, over pavement. I mean, wherever you got some space, you could fill some of these up, pull some soil, pop a hole in it, and start planting some plants today. They got a little kit here. This is 50 feet of garden soil, so you could have like a 50-foot long garden, whether you want to cut that in half and have two 25-foot long gardens or whatnot. And then you get an irrigation kit. So literally, if you just get the irrigation kit and this kit here, you could have a 50-foot garden, and then maybe the last thing you'll need is like an irrigation timer from a big box store to have it automatically water so that you can start growing some food. This is the easiest way to do it. And actually, because I'm here today, I'm sharing you guys a special coupon code for use on the website, gardensoxx.com. It's actually called CompostCon is a coupon code. It's gonna save you 20% off. And that's definitely for a limited time. So check it out and buy it and start growing today if you're not already. I mean, I think this is a valuable tool to use and a good way for a lot of people that may be renting, don't wanna like dig holes up in their lawn, build a raised bed. I mean, this is really portable and you can always move it and take it with you if you move. All right, so my time at the CompostCon has ended. I actually have to jet out of here and catch my flight to head off to somewhere else. But we're here with Wiggle E. Worm. And the message from Wiggle E. Worm, because they had a compost costume contest, is to compost at home, whether you're gonna do worm composting with Wiggly Worm, I wish I could take her home, or you know, whether you're just gonna do a static, you know, thermal-based compost, or even a fungal-dominated carbon-based compost where you don't really have to do anything. You just pile up wood chips and let them break down over the years. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode here at CompostCon. Once again, my name is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time. And remember, keep on composting. All right, this is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you, and this one's going to be a quick one at that. What we're going to do today is show you three easy, non-toxic,